Hello to all the friends and loyal followers of the Blue Cube YouTube channel. I hope you are doing well. I am Arash Adder, and in this video, I will continue teaching Adobe software. In this lesson, I'll show you how to apply constraints to character bones, edit characters, and also create controllers for character bones. Alright friends, if you've watched the previous tutorials, you know that we've already rigged the character, created a walk cycle, and basically prepared the character for animation. In the previous steps, I also turned the character into a symbol. Now you can see that I can move the character wherever I want using the transform tool. If I double-click on it, I'll enter the symbol editing mode. And if I select the selection tool and click, I can see the character's bone rig inside this section. One of the best ways to control a character is to create controllers. To do this, I first create a new layer. Then, using the shape tools, I select the rectangle tool and draw a rectangle like this. I select the free transform tool. You can also change the color from here. Let's make it green so it's easier to see. I right-click and choose Convert to Symbol, or you can press F8. Here, I select Graphic and click OK. Now, I make several copies by holding down the Alt key and dragging. I position one of these shapes under the hand, and I place the rectangle or square where I want it. With the zoom tool, I zoom in a bit. Using the selection tool, I click on the character so I can see the bones. Now I select the bone tool. I select the hand bone, which controls the wrist, and connect it to the square to create a bone. I repeat the same process for the other hand. For the legs, I do the same, from the ankle bone to the rectangle. I move these shapes around as needed. Again, I use the selection tool to select my shapes. I create the bones with the bone tool. Again, I select the bone tool and connect from one bone to another. Now I press this button so I can see the character centered on the screen, and I press Ctrl+1. Now, using the selection tool and these controllers, we can very easily move and control the hands, allowing us to create better animations. These controllers can help us a lot. For example, for making dance movements or other actions, we can use them for different purposes, and the same goes for the legs. You can see how easily we can do this. Now, I press Ctrl+Z. Now we need to hide the green color. All you have to do is select them with the free transform tool. If you want to select all of them together, hold down the Shift key and select the rest. If you move them, you'll see that they move together. Press Ctrl+Z to undo the move. Once all are selected, go to the Properties panel, select the Object or Control effect, choose the Alpha option, and set it to 0. Now, even though the controllers are invisible, with the selection tool you can still use them easily. Again, I press Ctrl+Z. For rotating and moving the bones and body parts, we need to set constraints so, for example, the character's hand or foot doesn't rotate too much. To do this and make animation easier, I zoom in a bit. I select the selection tool and click the head bone, which controls the head movement. In the joint rotation section, which is active, if I click this option, I can apply rotation limits to the bones. If you look here, it shows an angle range. For example, I set it to rotate from -45 to +45 degrees. This way, the head can only rotate within this range. I select it again and reduce the range. For example, -30 to +30 degrees is good for the head. Now, this is a better rotation limit. For the character's shoulder, which shouldn't rotate, I set the speed to 0 so it doesn't move, and I disable joint rotation so there's no rotation. Do the same for the other side. Set speed to 0 and joint rotation is disabled, so it can't rotate. Now I select the arm bone. I enable constrain, and from here, I can set the limit. Now, with constrain enabled, the arm only rotates 90 degrees by default, but I can increase that amount. Watch this section as the value changes. Now, you see the rotation range is suitable. I can select it again and increase the upper limit a bit more. Apply constraints for this bone as well. The arm shouldn't bend in the other direction, so select it and set the rotation as needed. Do the same for the other hand. Now it's good. Select the next bone and set its limits as well. You can also do this for the palm and wrist. The wrist shouldn't rotate too much. Select it, enable constrain, and set it to, say, minus 45 to plus 45 degrees, which works well. Do the same for the other wrist. Enable it here, set it to minus 45 to plus 45, and it's suitable. Now, pay attention. The character's spine should be able to bend. Select the spine bone and increase the speed so it can rotate better. When you bend the character, since we didn't design the character, we just used a photo, you'll see an empty space here because the character image only goes that far. To fix this, double-click the upper body with the free transform tool. Now you're in symbol editing mode. Draw a circle here and place it over this area. Adjust it as needed. Change the circle's color so it matches the body. Double-click the scene to go back. Now if you use the selection tool to rotate the character's waist, you'll see that you can bend it a bit. This bone shouldn't move because it'll mess up the character. Select the bone and set the speed to 0 so it doesn't move. Do the same for the thigh bone. Select it and enable constrain. Set the values. Do the same for the other thigh bone. Apply limits to the shin bone. The shin shouldn't bend forward. Select and set it to 0 in that direction and increase the other direction. When you bend the knee, if it doesn't look right, turn on the outlines and use the free transform tool to adjust the pivot point. Now it's better, so turn off outlines. Repeat the exact same steps for the other leg. Set the rotation range. For the ankle, select the bone and set it to rotate from minus 45 to plus 45 degrees, or even minus 30 to plus 30 if you prefer. Press Ctrl plus 1 to center the character. Now friends, if we move the character with the selection tool, we can easily animate the body without losing the natural pose. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. See you in the next video. Goodbye for now.